Hello everyone, I am Professor A.B. Zanzad. Today I am here to give a lecture on soil-water-plant relationship. First, we will see introduction. We know that soil and water are essential for plant growth. The soil provides a structural base to the plants and allows the root system to spread and get the stronghold. The pores of the soil within the root zone hold the moisture which clings to the soil particles by surface tension in the dry state, or may fill up the pores partially or fully, saturating it with the useful nutrients dissolved in water, which essential for growth of the plants. The roots of the most plants also require oxygen for the respiration. Hence, full saturation of the soil pores leads to restricted root growth of these plants. Irrigation practice is essentially an adequate and timely supply of water to the plant root zone for the optimum crop yield. Then, the next point is soil-water system. Soil is a heterogeneous mass consisting of a three-phase system of solid, liquid and gas. Mineral matter consisting of sand, silt and clay, and organic matter form the largest fraction of the soil and serves as the framework with numerous pores of various proportions. The white space between the solid soil particles is called as soil pore space. Decayed organic matter derived from the dead remains of plants and animals remains dispersed within the soil pore space. The soil air is totally expelled from soil when water is present in excess amount that can be stored. On the other extreme, when the total soil is dry, as in a hot region without any supply of water, either naturally by rain or artificially by irrigation, the water molecules surround the soil particles as thin film. In such a case, pressure lower than the atmospheric pressure thus results due to the surface tension capillarity, and it is not possible to drain out the water by means of gravity. The salts present in soil water further increase to this force by way of osmotic pressure. The root of a plant in such a condition need to exert at least an equal amount of force for extracting water from the soil mass for their growth. Soil properties. The important properties that classify soil according to its relevance to making crop production are soil texture and soil structure. First, we will see the soil texture. Soil texture refers to relative size of soil particle in a given soil. According to their size, soil particles are grouped into gravel, sand, silt and clay. The relative proportion of sand, silt, clay in soil mass determines the soil texture. The given figure also presents the textural classification of 12 main classes as identified by US Department of Agriculture, which is also followed by the Soil Survey Organization of India. According to textural gradations, soil may be classified as: first, open or light textured soils. These are mainly coarse or sandy with lower content of silt and clay. Then, medium textured soils. This contains sand, silt and clay in sizable proportions like loamy soil. And third, tight or heavy textured soil. This contains high proportion of clay. Then, the next point is soil structure. This refers to the arrangement of soil particles and aggregates with respect to each other. Aggregates are group of single kind of particles adhering together. Soil structure is recognized as one of the most important property of soil mass, as it influences aeration, water holding capacity and permeability, etc.
The classification of soil structure is done on basis of three indicators. First, type. There are four types of primary structures: platy, prism-like, block-like, and spheroidal. Then, class. There are five recognized classes in each of the type. They are very fine, fine, medium, coarse, and very coarse. Then third, grade. This represents the degree of aggregation, that is the proportion between aggregate and unaggregated material that results when the aggregates are displaced or gently crushed. Grades are termed as structureless, weak, moderate, strong, and very strong depending on the stability of aggregates when disturbed. Then the next topic is soil classification.
Soil varies widely in their characteristics and properties.
In India, the soil may be grouped into following types.
First, alluvial soil.
Second, black soil. Third, red soil. Fourth, laterites and lateritic soils. Five, desert soils. And last, problematic soils. First, alluvial soils. These soils are formed by the successive deposition of silts transported by rivers during floods in the floodplain and along the coastal belts. This group is by far the largest and the most important soil group of India, contributing the greatest share to its agricultural wealth. A great deal of variation exists in the type of alluvial soil present throughout the India. The main features of the soil are derived from the deposition laid by the numerous tributaries of the Indus, Ganga, and Brahmaputra river system. These streams draining the Himalayas bring with them the product of weathering rocks consisting the mountains in the various degrees of fineness and deposit them as traverse the plain. Alluvial soil textures vary from clay loam to sandy loam. The water holding capacity of the soil is fairly good and good for irrigation. Then next soil is black soil. These types of soil have evolved from the weathering of rocks such as basalt, traps, granites, and gneisses. Black soils are derived from the Deccan trap and are found in Maharashtra, western part of Madhya Pradesh, part of Andhra Pradesh, parts of Gujarat, and parts of Tamil Nadu. Black soils are heavy textured with the clay content varying from 40 to 60%. The soil possesses higher water holding capacity, but it is poor in the drainage. Then the next type of soil is red soil. These soils are formed by the weathering of igneous rocks and metamorphic rocks comprising gneisses and schists. They comprise of vast areas of Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Goa, Daman and Diu, southeastern Maharashtra, eastern Andhra Pradesh, Orissa and Jharkhand. They are also in Birbhum district of West Bengal, Mirzapur, Jhansi and Hamirpur district of Uttar Pradesh. The red soils have low water holding capacity and hence well drain.
Then, laterites and lateritic soils. Laterite is a formation particular to India and in other tropical countries with an intermittently moist climate. Laterite soils are derived from the weathering of laterite rocks and are well developed on the summit of hills of Karnataka, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh and eastern ghats of Orissa, Maharashtra, West Bengal, Assam and Tamil Nadu. These soils have low clay content and hence possess good drainage characteristics. Then next type is desert soil. A large part of arid region belonging to western Rajasthan, Haryana, Punjab, lying between the Indus River and Arauli Range, is affected by the desert conditions of the geological recent origin. This part is covered by a mantle of blown sand, which combined with the arid climate results in poor soil development. They are light textured sandy soils and react well to the application of irrigation water. Then problem soils. The problem soils are those which cannot be used for cultivation of crops without adopting proper reclamation measures. Highly eroded soils, ravine lands, soils on steep sloping lands, etc., constitute one set of problems, while acid, saline, alkaline constitute other sets of problems. Then some of the major soil groups of the country are listed below.
Then the next point is classification of soil otter. As we know, otter may occur in soil pores in various proportions. Some of the points related to the otter held in pores are as follows. First, gravitational otter. The volume of otter that a saturated soil sample drains out due to the gravity is called as gravitational otter. This otter is not available for plant use as it drains off rapidly from the root zone. Then second, capillary otter. The otter content retained in the soil after the gravitational otter has drained off from the soil is known as capillary otter. This otter is held in the soil by surface tension. Plant's root gradually absorb this otter, and thus it is the principal source of otter for the plant growth. Then hygroscopic otter. The otter that an oven dry sample of soil absorbs when exposed to moist air is termed as hygroscopic otter. It is held as very thin film over the surface of the soil particles and is under tremendous negative pressure. This otter is not available to the plants. Then the next point is soil otter constant. For a particular soil, certain soil otter proportions are defined which dictate whether the otter is available or not for the plant growth. These are called soil otter constants.
Saturation capacity. This is the total otter content of the soil when the pores of the soil
are completely filled with otter. It is also termed as maximum otter holding capacity of the soil. At saturation capacity, soil moisture tension is almost equal to zero. Then field capacity. This is the otter retained by initially saturated soil against the force of gravity. Hence, as gravitational otter gets drained off from the soil, it is said to reach the field capacity of the soil. At field capacity, the macro pores of the soil are drained off, but otter is retained in the micro pores. Normally, the soil moisture tension lies between 1/10 for clay soils to 1/3 for sandy soil atmosphere.
Permanent wilting point. Plant roots are able to extract otter from a soil matrix which is saturated up to a field capacity. However, as the otter extraction proceeds, the moisture content diminishes and the negative pressure increases. At one point, plant cannot extract any further otter and thus wilts. Two stages of wilting point are recognized, and they are termed as first temporary wilting point and second ultimate wilting point. First, temporary wilting point. It denotes the soil otter content at which the plants wilt at daytime but recover during the night time or when otter is added to the soil. Ultimate wilting point. At such a soil otter content, the plants wilts and fails to regain life even after the addition of the otter to the soil. The available otter for plants is defined as the difference in moisture content of the soil between field capacity and permanent wilting point. All the soil constants are expressed as a percentage by
weight of moisture available at that point compared to the weight of the dried soil and dried soil sand sample. Here we covered the lecture on soil otter plant relationship. To get more videos related to agriculture and agricultural engineering, please subscribe the AgroNear channel. Thank you.